It's almost time for a very special day. Can you guess why? No, it's not my birthday. Guess again. No, it's not the day of the big parade either. It's the longest day of the year, and it's the first official day of summer. There are lots of days that might seem really long. Maybe you felt that way when you were excited about something that was going to happen, like your birthday or the first day of vacation. The day before an exciting event can seem like it takes a long time, but even if a day feels that way, it's not really any longer. All days have the same amount of time in them, about 24 hours. When we say it's the longest day of the year, what we really mean is that there's the longest amount of daylight, which means the sun is up for the longest amount of time, and it's dark for the shortest amount of time. This special day is called the summer solstice, and when it happens, it's officially summer. Have you ever noticed that in the winter, it gets dark pretty early? It's probably dark before you even go to bed. But in the spring and summer, like now, the sun goes down much later. Yes, that's exactly what you asked about the other day. Squeaks asked if he could change his bedtime so it's after dark, since he doesn't like going to sleep when it's still light out. But instead, we just changed his curtains so they make the room darker, and that helped, right? We have a summer solstice every year because of the way our planet moves around the sun. And how it's tilted. Because even though you don't feel it, the Earth is always moving. It takes a whole year for the Earth to go around the sun one time. And while it's moving around the sun, Earth is also spinning around in place around an imaginary line that we call the axis. The Earth's axis runs up and down, right through the North Pole and the South Pole. One turn on the Earth's axis takes 24 hours, and that's what makes one day. But there's something else about the Earth's axis. It isn't exactly straight up and down. It's tilted just a little bit. And it's this tilt that causes the summer solstice. Right now, the tilt is pointing the northern or top half of the Earth toward the sun, which means that during one spin, which remember is 24 hours, a whole day and night, the top half of the Earth spends more time in the sun than in the dark. The summer solstice is when the tilt is pointing us exactly toward the sun. Here in the top half of the world, that's usually on June 21st, although it's sometimes on June 20th or 22nd. Soon, the tilt will start to point more sideways compared to the sun, and eventually it'll face away from the sun on what we call the winter solstice. That will be the shortest day of the year with the least amount of sunlight. But for now, while we're pointed toward the sun, we get long sunny days. For people who live in the southern half of the world, everything is opposite. When the Earth's tilt points the top half of the world toward the sun, it points the bottom half away from the sun. So for people who live in places like Australia or South America, it's about to be the shortest day of the year, not the longest. Their winter solstice is the same day as our summer solstice, and their summer solstice is the same day as our winter solstice. Since it's almost our summer solstice and the first day of summer, I'm going to stock up on some sunscreen. Squeaks and I hope you have a happy solstice, whether it's summer or winter. Thanks for joining us. If you want to keep learning and having fun with Squeaks and me, hit the subscribe button and don't forget to check us out on the YouTube Kids app. Thanks, and we'll see you next time here at the Fort.